This VAP is on vaginal discharge. By the end of this VAP, the normal vaginal environment is acidic, with a pH of 3.8 to 4.4, thus discouraging infections. This environment is created by normally occurring bacterial lactobacilli. Any disruption to the pH balance of the vaginal environment can make it more conducive to infection. Physiological vaginal discharge is normal and consists of vaginal secretions. Contribution to vaginal secretions include secretions from sebaceous, sweat, betuline, and skin glands, transudate from the vaginal wall, exfoliated vagina and cervical cells, cervical mucus, endometrial and oviductal fluid. Physiological discharge is also influenced by hormone levels. The pH balance of the vagina is the least acidic on the days just prior to and during menstruation. Infections are thus most common at this time. There is also a normal increase of discharge around mid-cycle. Pregnancy also increases physiological discharge. Vaginal discharge can be either physiological or pathological. Pathological causes can be further divided into infective or non-infective causes. The commonest cause is physiological, but infective causes should be excluded. We will be focusing on the major common causes of infective vaginal discharge, mainly bacterial vaginosis, vulvovaginal candidiasis, and Trichomonas vaginalis. The following diagnostic approach is recommended. First, a thorough history must be obtained. Details about the vaginal discharge include the onset, duration, color, and odor. Associated symptoms such as vaginal itch, rash, and dysuria are suggestive of infective vaginal discharge. A sexual history is used to assess the risk of STIs. Risk factors include age less than 25 years, change of new sexual partner in the last year, and more than one sexual partner in the last year. Similar symptoms in partners should be covered. Medical history is important as immunocompromised states like diabetes and HIV can predispose to infection. Current and previous medication, menstrual history, and obstetric history should be obtained too. Next, perform a physical examination. Inspection of the external genitalia and perianal areas are done to look for inflammation and other lesions. A speculum examination allows one to inspect the vaginal and cervical region. Attention to the appearance and character of discharge is important, including the consistency and odor. Not all women with vaginal discharge require investigations. Empirical treatment can be given if the patient is at low risk of STI and has no symptoms to suggest upper genital tract infection. The description in the top right blue box gives a clue as to the potential infection. Investigations are indicated if a woman is at high risk of STIs, has symptoms suggestive of upper genital tract infection, for example, abdominal pain, dyspareunia, or fever, has previous treatment which has failed, is postnatal, post-miscarriage or post-abortion, or is within 3 weeks of insertion of an intrauterine contraceptive device. Investigations include high vagina swabs, which are used to diagnose the common cause such as candida, bacterial vaginosis, and trichomonas. Endocervical swabs are used to diagnose certain sexually transmitted diseases, like chlamydia and gonorrhea. Bacterial vaginosis is the most common cause of vaginal discharge in women of reproductive age. However, up to 50% of women with a clinical diagnosis of BV are asymptomatic. BV is due to an overgrowth of organisms. This occurs when there is an alteration of normal vaginal flora, causing a loss of lactobacilli, thus disrupting the pH balance of the vaginal environment and increasing the pH. The organisms responsible are predominantly anaerobic and include Gonorrhea vaginalis, Mycoplasma hominis, and Moby lucus. An isolation of gonorrhea vaginalis alone should not be used as a diagnostic test for BV, as between 35 to 55% of women are carriers of this organism. Predisposing factors include repeated alkalinization of the vagina, for example, with douching and frequent sexual intercourse. BV increases the risk of post-abortion endometritis and pelvic inflammatory disease. In pregnancy, it is associated with late miscarriage, preterm delivery in high-risk pregnancies, preterm premature rupture of membranes, and postpartum endometritis. BV is usually diagnosed using M-cells criteria, where at least three of the following four conditions must be met. Number 1, a raised vaginal pH of more than 4.5. Number 2, teen homogeneous grey or white vaginal discharge. Number 3, the presence of clue cells on wet preparation microscopy. And number 4, a positive amine test demonstrated by the release of the fishy odour on mixing vaginal discharge with 10% potassium hydroxide. Organisms are cultured from a high vaginal swab for diagnosis. All symptomatic women with bacterial vaginosis or asymptomatic women with BV before surgical procedures should be treated. BV can be treated with either oral metronidazole or clindamycin for 7 days. Treatment in pregnancy is the same as in non-pregnant women. Overall cure rates range from 75 to 85%, and follow-up is not necessary if symptoms resolve. Recurrent BV occurs within 3 months of treatment in about 15 to 30% of women. Suppressive regimens may be considered, but evidence to support their effectiveness is limited. Maintenance with ascitic acid vagina gel at the time of menstruation and following unprotected sexual intercourse maintains acidic vaginal pH. Candidiasis is a fungal infection mostly caused by the species Candida albicans. Candida albicans is responsible for 80 to 92% of cases. Other species of Candida, such as Candida galbrata and Candida topicalis, tend to be resistant to therapy. Predisposing factors to infection include immunosuppression, antibiotic use, high estrogen levels that occur with oral contraceptive pills and hormone replacement therapy usage, pregnancy, diabetes mellitus, and prolonged corticosteroid therapy. Typical Candida infection presents with thick, white, curly cottage cheese-like discharge associated with vaginal itch and soreness. Occasionally, it can be associated with superficial dyspareunia or external dysuria. Clinically, vulvovaginal erythema and excoriation is common. A high vaginal swab is used for diagnosis. E cells are seen on Gram stain microscopy. There are various preparations of drugs that can be used for treatment. All topical and oral azole therapies give a cure rate of 80 to 90%. In pregnancy, asymptomatic colonization with Candida is common at 30 to 40%. No treatment is necessary unless patients are asymptomatic. Oral azole is contraindicated and should not be used in pregnancy. Longer courses of topical azole for 7 days is recommended instead. Nystatin preparations have a 70 to 90% cure rate. They are the first-line treatment for non-albicans infection. Patients should avoid local irritants such as tight clothing or perfumed vagina douche. Topical creams or antihistamines can be used to relieve itch. Recurrent infection is defined as 4 or more episodes of symptomatic infection annually, with positive microscopy of Candida on at least 2 episodes. For acute treatment of the infection, an induction regimen of oral azole is repeated every 3 days for 3 doses. Following that, either maintenance regimen is used for 6 months. Trichomonal vaginitis is caused by the parasite Trichomonas vaginalis. It is the only sexually transmitted vaginal infection of the 3 infections discussed. However, unlike chlamydia and gonorrhea, it does not affect extragenital sites, but can infect the vagina, urethra, and periurethral glands. Partners in the last 2 months should be screened and treated. Testing for other infections include BV and other STIs should be considered, as 60% of patients have BV and 30% have chlamydia or gonorrhea. The graph shows the concurrent STIs found in the survey of women with Trichomonas infection. Clinical diagnosis is typically identified by a yellow-green foul-smelling discharge associated with vulvovaginal erythema and excoriation, with a strawberry cervix present in 2% of patients. Investigations will reveal a raised pH with motile trichomonas seen on microscopy. First-line treatment requires systemic rather than topical treatment. Because the infection is not always confined to the vagina, but may involve other parts of the urogenital tract. Oral metronidazole for 1 week gives a cure rate of 90 to 95%, compared to 50% with topical treatment. Patients with persistent symptoms should be retreated with oral metronidazole 400 mg BD for another 7 days. Repeated failure of treatment may require high-dose oral metronidazole of 2 grams daily for 3 days. Sexual partners should also be treated, as this will improve cure rates. This is the end of the VAP. Further reading references are as stated.